Redeeming the Revelation 12 Sign Days. My name is Daniel Vallis, and welcome to our channel. And also welcome to the Brook Cherith. We are at an amazing time, and we can see on the timeline there is so much that tells us we should be watching and looking up with great expectation. Definitely review the timeline every single day. You can find a link in the description box. It is vitally important to review the timeline because it summarizes and shows us all the different things that are happening at the same time. Biblical patterns and examples, celestial events on the celestial clock, what's going on here on the ground level with the Brook Cherith, and basically a summary overview of the celestial and prophetic time. The biblical time right here, so much we've been told to look up, to lift up our heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. And particularly when we are at a time on the celestial calendar that even draws our attention to the lamb and the fish, and how they also go together, but then also the biblical time, the commemorative time leading up toward Pentecost, leading even up to the ascension, which happened before that, and even how Christ even brought up the subject when he was talking about it even prior to the ascension. All right in this window, this time frame where we are right now, there is a lot that we should be considering, reviewing, and reflecting about what our own Redeemer has told us when he told us, look up. And the more that we look up and we review what we are looking at, the more we can recall what he has said, the promises our Redeemer has said that do connect to our redemption, the promise redemption, the promise pickup. And particularly at this time on the timeline with these events of the ascension particularly, we are reminded of the Harpazo promise. Definitely check out that poster in the Rapture Library as well. There are so many things about our own redemption that are exuded at this time frame over these days and weeks ahead where we are looking at right now. And the more you look at the timeline, you need to ask yourself this question. Why are we looking at this particular time? Why are we looking at this prophetic time? Why do we see these days approaching? Why are we even on this channel watching these videos? Why? Because our Lord has shown us certain things. He has brought you, he has brought me across different paths of studying what Scripture says, what our Redeemer has said, how he has told us to see and look for certain events and then look up. There is going to be more investigation, more study. And as Bereans, he wants us to go forward to study and search out the treasures that he has. He has told us how to start, look up, lift up your heads. And you also know why you should, for your redemption draweth nigh. We know we are in a countdown of time within this last generation, a countdown of time. We are running out of time. This is why we are told to redeem the time. And the more we review the timeline, and the more we review, why am I even looking at this timeline? Why am I even looking at the prophetic time? Why am I even looking up? We should always come back to the same conclusion. Because we know we are running out of time. Do you know what time it is? And if you do know what time it is, reflect and consider, why do you know what time it is? Why do you see the day approaching? What has the Lord used to show you and bring you to this place? And the more we reflect on the paths and the process, the watchmen, the different sources, the different means, how Christ has even worked in our own lives and different examples, there are so many reasons why we see the day approaching. There's a lot of factual and statistical information, if you will, that we could put on the timeline that definitely helps us to review and reflect on everything that sometimes we forget. And, oh yeah, that picture is here. Oh yeah, that's commemorated this time of year too. And, oh, this is coming up. There's a lot that it does us so well to review the timeline when we remember why do we see the day approaching? Why are we even looking at this time? Do we know what time it is? And particularly here, we've been looking at the Revelation 12 sign, the day counts that follow after that. Scripture gives three different day counts. And as we mentioned in our last video, Scripture does not tell us why those day counts are given or what specifically happens at those day counts. They're closely related. They're only a few days apart from each other. It doesn't tell us, oh, this important event's going to happen at this one and this one or this one. It just says, this is going to be important, this one's going to be important, and this one's going to be important too. So again, the role of the Berean comes up again, where we have to search Scripture and search out the limits of what it does say, how it does hint, and how it also does want us to search out things. Search the Scriptures, and then to also examine and to watch, look up, watch it unfold. There's going to be certain things that you learn as it unfolds. And so this is what we've been doing with the timeline, particularly with the day counts associated with the Revelation 12 sign. We've put them on. We have been watching them, the 1,260 days, the 1,290 days, these different markers. And we also see coming up in about 40-some days is the 1,335 days. Again, Scripture does not tell us why it gave those earlier day counts, although it does tell us with the 1,260 days, the woman will be protected during that duration. But we also don't know if that 1,260 days is counting backwards either from the 1,335 days. All we know is Scripture gives us these day counts and that they are significant transitions pegged to the Revelation 12 sign. So we are going to watch them. And again, the more that we watch them and then see how it falls right at a particular time, right in the springtime, right with the celestial clock reminding us of our Redeemer, the whole reason for our redemption, the very one who promised that he would come and pick us up and take us to where he is one day. There is so many things that remind us collectively about why we are watching this time. And the more that we remember why we are watching this time, the more that emphasizes the time and that we are running out of time. We do not know the exact day or hour, but we are told by our Redeemer himself that we will see and know that our redemption draweth nigh, that a countdown is in effect, that we are running out of days, we are running out of hours. And the Apostle Paul echoed the same thing. You will see the day approaching. You will see it approaching because you will realize you are running out of time. Those days are disappearing more and more and more. You will see it drawing nigh. You will see it approaching. You won't know the exact day or hour, but you will have a very strong understanding that you are running out of those days and hours. There is going to be a window very particularly that you should be watching, that you should be looking. And this is Christ, again, a repeated warning and command. Watch. You don't have to understand everything. He doesn't say, make sure you understand every single detail. No, he just says, watch it. Observe it. What I tell you, follow it. Put it on timelines. Take notes about it. Follow what I say. Look up. It's going to be very important for you once you start realizing that you are running out of time and that your redemption draweth nigh. You're going to have to do that. You may not understand everything, but you will understand you are running out of time. There is going to be a window when you will know you should be watching and when you should be redeeming what time is left, understanding how valuable and important it is prophetically. And so as we see these day counts associated with the Revelation 12 sign, and again, everything happening here in connection on the biblical calendar, the different commemorations that are going on right now, there is so much that is telling us that we need to be watching, we need to be sober, we need to be taking heed to ourselves, examining what we are doing. Are we caught up in the cares of this life at this time? There is so much, the more that we review the timeline, reflecting on the time, how we are running out of time, that it should cause reflection on how we are living within that time. Are we taking heed to ourselves? Are we watching? Watching not just the prophetic events, not just the geopolitical events, but are we watching ourselves? Do we know what time it is? And it has been incredible within the past few weeks and months to see how so much has been accelerating, what the Lord is working. We've seen so much on this journey, on this learning journey, that the Lord has been working here at this ministry at the Brook Cherith through this channel to show you through this channel the shortness of time, that we need to be redeeming the time. God has used particularly this channel, many other watchmen as well, but particularly this channel to really focus on a larger picture, the celestial clock, how we should be looking up, how we should be lifting up our heads, and then putting that into action. As we see the day approaching, we should be doing something. We should be girded in his service. We should be found with our lights burning. Christ does not just want us to have a head knowledge full of trivia information when he comes. He wants to find us busy living out that we know time is short and our redemption draweth nigh. And what we do in these last prophetic hours here at this last generation time is going to be incredibly important. And he wants to find us busy in his service when he comes. It is the understanding of the time that should be reflected how we live and act in that time. And one thing that I've been reflecting on the past few days is particularly working on the Rapture Libraries. Again, reflecting on why are we even looking at this time? And then the more that I've reviewed and considered all the things that the Lord has brought me on my learning journey and the different prophetic information that we've covered for years now, understanding my view of why I know time is short and why I've always for years been emphasizing to people, do you know what time it is? There is a reason why we know time is short. There is a reason. Do you know what time it is? If you don't know what time it is, you better start watching what Christ said. Because that day is drawing nigh. That day is approaching whether you are watching or not. The question is, are we going to be found wise and faithful? Or foolish and wicked, not taking heed to even ourselves, just living for ourselves instead of living for our Redeemer when we know that time is short. There should be a reason when we look back recently over the past weeks and months and years, realizing how the Lord has shown us and brought to our attention why we know time is short. And the more that we reflect on the weight of everything that he has shown us. That should also reinforce and really give us a sense of urgency how short time is, that our Father has shown us and given us so much information ahead of time so that we can be fully informed, so that we can be busy here at these late midnight hours with our lights burning, girded in his service. And so before we look into the day counts some more, let's again review. What is the Lord working here at the Brook Cherith on the ground level? Because this is directly related to why we know the time is short. Because what the Lord is working now on the ground level is a reflection and really an end goal, a conclusion of what he started years ago when he showed us and started to catch our attention that, hey, you are running out of time. What we are seeing the Lord work now here on the ground level with the rapture libraries and collecting all that information, it should really cause us to reflect, why do we know the time? It's because our Father has been trying to tell us the time for so many years right now. And it's finally building to where he's showing us the pile of evidence of how short time is. So that even reinforces even more in us the attention to what the Lord is working with the rapture libraries, realizing he is showing us a whole heap of information that tells us our redemption draweth nigh, that we see the day approaching, that is practically right on top of us. Because the more that we actually build out a rapture library, compiling all this information, we start to consider and understand the vastness of everything that the Lord has shown us on this learning journey. And I've said this before, this rapture library is not just for those in the days ahead. It is for us today. Today, you need to be going through the rapturelibrary.com, reviewing all the information that our Father has shown you, why you know the time, why you know the day is approaching, why you know our redemption draweth nigh. Because he has shown us so much, and the more that we look at it, and the more that we go through it, we shouldn't say, well, I already know all that stuff. We should look at it and say, why do I know this? Because my Father showed it to me. He gave me wisdom. He brought me across paths and teachers and watchmen and Bible study to bring all this together. Showing the celestial events, the geopolitical events, bringing it all together. There's a whole mountain of evidence of why we know the hour is late. And here our Father is actually taking us through the process of reviewing all the information that he has shown us over years now, for the sole purpose of condensing all that information for those in the days ahead who won't have that luxury of all those years that you and I have had the luxury of going through. We've been able to take it at a slower pace, you know, some here, some there. We got busy with life and all that stuff. So again, this should drive it home for us how important and how late the hour is that our Father is now having us collect, review, and condense all this information to pass it on to those in days ahead. We are passing on our learning journey. We all have the ministry opportunity, a mission to pass on a condensed learning journey for those in the days ahead who will not have the luxury, who will not have the opportunity that you and I have been graced by our Father with, that luxury of time. And so we all, you and me, have the opportunity to all bear forth all this information for those in the days ahead, so that they can learn and be caught up on so much information, the lateness of the hour, what's going on. We can pass on your and mine learning journey to those in the days ahead. They won't have YouTube. They certainly won't have the luxury of time. The Lord is giving us information from our own learning journey, from our own experiences, to pass on for those in days ahead, where we can say, here, this is what the Lord showed us. This is why I understood the lateness of the hour. This is why I saw the day approaching. This is everything that guided my understanding. Here, it's condensed for you. It is a whole ministry opportunity for us to take what our Father has given us. And if we will not take what our Father has given us and not even have the heart and desire to pass it on to those in the days ahead, then shame on us. Shame on us. It should be our heart's cry. The more that we review everything that our Father has shown us, the wealth of information that our Father has shown us, to then go forward and invest that in others, to share it with others, with the hope and prayer that the Lord will use it to bring so many souls to salvation in the days ahead. We have been given an incredible opportunity, an incredible investment. The more that we reflect on why do we know time is short, the more that we know time is short, the more that we know that our redemption draweth nigh, the more that we see the day approaching, the more we realize how valuable what we have been shown at this time that makes the time so valuable to redeem. Because there are so many condensed opportunities within this time. Let us redeem the time. And praise the Lord, it is amazing to see how the Lord is giving so much wisdom for the rapture libraries to pass on the encapsulated information, the condensed information from our learning journey, years worth of information, being able to pass on to those in the days ahead. This, it really is so mind-blowing to consider that the Lord is even giving us this opportunity. He's not just giving us the opportunity, but He's already given us all the information in print form too. It is so incredible. And on rapturelibrary.com, you can just download it and print it all off for your own use too at your rapture library, at your embassy. There is so much opportunity with so much weight. The more that we consider, our Father took years to show this to us. What are we doing with all this treasure He has put into our hand? Are we investing it in the lives of others? Or are we just wrapping up all that treasure into a napkin and burying it and not acting on it, hoping our Master doesn't say anything about it in the days ahead? No, we need to be busy with what our Master has given, investing it in the time He has shown us so that we are redeeming the time to bring forth fruit for His glory. And so it is incredible. The Lord keeps giving more wisdom, just more tweaks and touches with the rapture libraries. I made a few adjustments in the Spanish library, giving them their own quieter reading area. I moved it off to the side, just like in the English rapture library. Switched things around with the study and reference area as well. So the Lord is definitely using this time. This is going to be a one-shot opportunity. We're taking years of information and condensing it into, it looks large, but it really is a small space. But so much information has to be packed into there. There is definitely a lot of detail and thought being put into this. We're not rushing this at all. We are going forward as the Lord gives liberty for each step. So I'm definitely doing a lot of research and scenarios because we only have one shot on this opportunity, this prophetic opportunity, one shot. So it needs to be done right the first time. And we go forward as the Lord gives liberty. He wants us to dwell on certain areas, study and do research, make sure certain areas are done right. And then as we do that, and we can do that well, then He can take us to the next step. And so much is coming together, especially in the preparation and staging areas. We've been able to get a pallet jack. We've been organizing a lot of the material, a lot of furniture and reading nooks, putting them on the pallets even ready to roll out. So as soon as the trailers get here, we can roll a lot of these supplies, even the lumber and the wood wall panels, roll them right up next to the trailer, just start loading them up right away. There is so much that's going to happen quickly because of all this pre-planning, because of all this staging, because of all the preparation, because of all this work. Praise the Lord, significant amount of work and planning has also been going into the Rapture Services trailer. We've got one of the pumps, some of the hoses and fittings. We've already worked up a lot of the schematics for how all this will work together. We got the 3 tote tanks, 2 holding tanks, and 1 utility water tote tank. We've been busy. There's so much going on. We are definitely not sitting around waiting. There is so much that has to be done. And praise the Lord, I was able to get the battery backup rack for the Spanish library done as well the other day. There is so much coming together, enabling these libraries to show and share this information of what the Lord has shown us. And praise the Lord, we got a few more posters the other day. And some of these are now in the Rapture Library as well, especially the Biblical Prophecies of the Middle East and especially the Last Generation. And this poster is really instrumental to our understanding of the learning journey because, as I've mentioned before in previous videos, it was back in 2012 on literally the last day of the Olympics with all the events that are happening there and the huge life change events that happened there as well. The understanding then of how just the days previous to that, the Lord really drove it home how late the hour is. And the reason we have an understanding of the time is by looking at the Last Generation. And Christ's repeated emphasis that all the prophetic events, all of them, including the tribulation events, will happen within the generation that sees Israel replanted. And so once you start seeing that generation of people who were alive when that happened, there will also be some of that generation alive when the conclusion of those prophetic events finishes as well. So Christ told us ahead of time a time frame, a general time frame of when things will happen, when you will expect all the rest of the events to happen, when you should be looking up, when the world will see the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, when so many things are going to happen within a certain window. And you should not be surprised that they happen within a certain window when you start looking and start realizing, oh, we are in the last generation, and oh, wow, we're toward the latter end of that last generation too. And oh, look, there's celestial signs, rare celestial signs. There is so much going on right within the generation when Christ said all these things will be happening. This is why we know the lateness of the hour, because we can see in the real world the reality of Scripture, our Redeemer's promises. And He said within this window is when your redemption, when your pickup, the harpazo promise will be. And when you see that day approaching, you need to take heed to yourself that you're not caught up in the cares of this life because things are about to drastically change. And this world is not your home. You need to be girded in service with your lights burning when you know time is short, when you are watching the time, when you are watching the days and hours run out, when you know the time you should be living like it. And that is what will make you a wise and faithful servant. And it all goes back to, why are we even looking at this time? It's the last generation. That is the starting point. Once you understand the last generation, when to watch, you will then so much more easily see everything else that Christ said you will see within this window. And so the Lord's really used this the past few days just for me reflecting as I've been working on this rapture library and getting all these posters and material ready. I'm just, a lot of it for me is a deja vu journey of, oh wow, I remember when we made this, Lord, this was so cool. And wow, that was back in 2013. That was a long time ago. Time flies. And so that's what's been so incredible for me is when I look at the timeline today, I realize, why am I even looking at the timeline today? It's because of what our Father showed us way back in 2012, 2013. We're still watching the exact same things unfold that He said would unfold. And the signs that we've seen with the Revelation 12 sign, all those events, and the Star of Bethlehem reminder signs, we've not been surprised at all to see that happen right when Christ said, look up, pay attention. There will be things happening within this time frame, and you will know that your redemption draweth nigh. You will see the day approaching if you are watching. If you are watching. And this is why we need to watch the timeline, friend. We view the timeline, because the more that we put our eyeballs on the timeline, the more we'll remember why we are even looking at this time, and that we are running out of time, and that we need to be redeeming the time. Indeed, as we consider the day counts that go with the Revelation 12 sign, we really need to back up. And again, for me, my personal learning journey of why was I even looking at the Revelation 12 sign in the first place? Reviewing all these posters and everything, going back to 2013, the past few days, the Lord has really had me in reflection mode, just reflecting everything that the Lord has worked in my own life here at the Brook Cherith, why I'm even working on the Rapture Library. It's because of what our Lord started back in 2012, 2013. And the more that I look at it in the larger picture, I'm not surprised at all that the Lord is having us work on the Rapture Library now, condensing everything that He showed us years ago, because back then we knew the time was short. In late 2012, that's when I had just a basic understanding of that we were entering the latter part of the last generation, and I started to do more study on it after that, definitely as the Lord gave more time after the ministry events there. But for those who have been with us for a long time, and I do mean a long time, going back to 2013, you will remember that is when we published our last generation poster, the infographic that lays it all out. It is back in the middle of 2013, from the study that happened over the months previous to that. We've had an understanding of this time for a long time. And that whole latter time of 2013, that's when we were developing the Antichrist deception information, the mark of the beast, biblical studies, more studies about the Revelation events and everything, how Christ will even intervene and how time will be adjusted within the tribulation. We had some early ideas of that even at that time in 2013. But that's also when we put out our poster, Signs in the Heavens, which talked about the Revelation 12 sign and the blood moons and how there was the understanding that there were 1,260 days before the Revelation 12 sign and 1,260 days after that. We were already studying all that information way back in 2013. Even back then, we were talking about how March 6, 2021 would be the end of the count for 1,260 days. We understood that there were the other counts too, and we also talked about how there could be some wiggle room because Christ is going to intercede and shorten the days, and there's going to be something happening with time there in the middle, but generally it will bring you to March 6, 2021 at a base understanding. And so again, friend, I want you to realize where we are now in 2021, it's because of information the Lord has shown us back in 2012 and 2013 here at this channel. Certainly other and older watchmen have covered it for far longer than I have, but this, on our particular learning journey, that's when the Lord was really emphasizing. This celestial sign is going to be coming up. There's a certain day count associated prior to that. There's also certain day counts associated after that. And all of this falls within the last generation. You should not be surprised that this major, rare celestial event is coming up. And so a lot of our learning journey has been diving in like Bereans. What is the importance of the sign? What is the different mile markers of events. How does this fit in the sign of the Son of Man? We are told the world will see it during this last generation time, and this fits the bill, particularly with the Star of Bethlehem sign that happened right before it, and it's the exact lead-in celestially to it, and a rare celestial sign that hadn't happened in 2,000 years since the time of Christ came the first time anyway. There have been so many celestial signs that we knew ahead of time, before we even saw them physically with our eyeballs, we could see back in 2012 and 2013 that this is coming up. It's coming up in the last generation. And the last time this one happened was at the time of Christ. And we are expecting our Redeemer, Christ, to come again and take us to where He is. There's a lot that we have known for years that told us time is drawing nigh. The day is approaching, the day of that pickup, the day of the rest of the prophetic events that will happen within the last generation. Our understanding of why we know the time, why we're even looking at the Revelation 12 day counts, falls within the whole umbrella of the last generation. This is what we've been looking at. And the Lord has given so much information early on in the learning journey. And again, this is on my learning journey. This is even before I started the YouTube channel. We, of course, had our ministry, informedchristians.com, for many years, going back to 2003. We've covered a lot of this information unfolding as we studied it on the website before it crashed. So keep in mind that a lot of the material that we've been covering on the YouTube channel, and particularly even now, it's all a result of what the Lord showed us early on. And it has really guided our understanding this whole time from even before we started the YouTube channel. We've made the information available to last generation. This is one of the big reasons why we put all of our information into print form. People can't go back and watch the entire channel's worth of videos. Nobody has time for that. But we can pass on the printed information, the library of the concise information that we have learned along this journey. This is why it's so vitally important that you print off information for those in the days ahead. They're not going to have time to watch videos. Give them print information. So everything about the last generation, the Antichrist, the mark of the beast, the events, even with the Revelation 12 sign and how there will be an adjustment of time, we understood that, had a base understanding of that even back in 2013. And then more study throughout 2014, 2015, that's when the Lord really started getting more information about time, the role of time when the Antichrist will be handed power to change times and laws with the time machine hamster wheel project sign. That was a sign that the Lord gave because of research over the months prior to that. And it was in April 2015 that we compiled together a lot of that information that we finally verified and could really conclude upon with the time sign in the Bible. Not just the video, but the print form. All of our time material is in print form in our time folder in the Google Drive. That's when the Lord also pointed out the role of the Antichrist. Understanding time, you got to understand who the Antichrist is. The Lord gave wisdom all this early on. How does the technology work? Who developed the technology? Who was changing time already? Who is coming back? Who is returning? The Lord gave so much information early on, even before the first Star of Bethlehem sign, that rare astronomical event. Even before we started the YouTube channel as a time of study and understanding the subjects, how they fit into prophecy, before we could pass them on to an even larger audience with the YouTube channel. And what the Lord is working now with the Rapture Library is going to the next level, even larger than a YouTube channel, passing on this concise information in print form for those in the days ahead. As we go through our learning journey, we have the responsibility to pass on that information to those who follow after us. That's what I did between 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015, with all that information, taking my journey, passing it on to you. Now we have the other opportunity to pass it on to those beyond us, those in the prophetic days ahead. The more that we reflect on where we are now, we need to reflect on why are we here now? Why are we looking at this time now? And the more that we see the day approaching, the more we should see the opportunities in reflection of what our Father has shown us and worked in our lives to where we pass that on and act on what He has shown us. If you watched our time countdown and the related videos with that, you'll remember with the Star of Bethlehem sign that hadn't happened in 2,000 years. It was hours after that the Lord opened up the opportunity for our time patterns and changes, presentation at a local church, and to do a live test on the people as well. And if you've watched that video, you may have heard me emphasize, do you know what time it is? Why was there that sense of urgency? Because of the months and years of study that our Father has shown us prior to that, leading up to that. All that He has worked on the learning journey up to that, that built the understanding at that point to where the Lord could say, okay, now you have a solid understanding of all this. Now present it, test it, and demonstrate it. Share it with others, and then go forward from there. And it wasn't until late 2015 that we started really our YouTube channel start making the Situation Room videos. We had a few videos before that, but that's when we really started diving into, let's start making concise videos to share with people how short time is, because we're running out of time. There's so many things that are happening right now when we should be looking up and lifting up our heads. And so it has been incredible how what the Lord has shown us on our learning journey has compounded. There's been a compounded interest of the wisdom that the Lord has shown us the more that we share it with others. We get greater blessing and understanding when we share and we act on what our Father shows us. When we are wise and faithful with what our Father shares with us when we share with others. And all of this sharing is a result of understanding the lateness of the hour, the prophetic time. What time is it? Let's be found redeeming the time. So we act on what we know. We put action with what we know. We go forward in faith with what Scripture says, the promises of our Redeemer. And so now we are at a very important time where we are looking at day counts that are associated with the Revelation 12 sign. We've seen the sign, the rare celestial sign that has never happened before. We have that whole detailed in the Rapture Library, the Revelation chapter 12 sign book. We've been told to look up prior to the tribulation, the ones before the tribulation. We are told to look up and to lift up our heads because we will see major celestial signs on the celestial clock. And that is part of our understanding our redemption draweth nigh. Before the rapture, before the tribulation starts, we are told to look up. And we are to take note of what we see when we do look up, understanding that it is connected to running out of time and our redemption. They do go together. And there's also the understanding that during the tribulation, they will see the sign of the Son of Man again. They will see the same things that we were told to look up and see. And they will have greater understanding in those days if we could pass on the notes from what we saw and condense the years of understanding and observation, pass it on to them for what they will see as well. Now again, with the Revelation 12 sign, Scripture records three different day counts, but it does not tell us exactly what's going to happen on each one. And there's already the general understanding that the two witnesses will testify for 1,260 days prior to the midst of the tribulation. And apparently after that, after the witnesses are gone, that's when the beast has more power to really start persecuting. And that's when he starts really demanding that people bow down, worship the beast, and take the mark of his name. But prior to that, the two witnesses will definitely be a monkey wrench in what he's trying to do. They will definitely cause a lot of interference. There's a whole reason why the world rejoices when they're dead, because they do interfere with what the beast is trying to do. And once they are gone, then he has a lot more liberty. And we know that there is going to be a period after the midst of 1,260 days where the woman will be protected for that duration. Now, the Bible does not specifically say that it starts exactly on the Revelation 12 sign, although the inference is there. And the inference is that the other day counts come afterwards, but it does not specifically say that. It's actually vague. And so when Scripture is actually vague, we need to leave it open that it could be moved around. There's a base understanding that we should go, that yes, you should at least start understanding that it's probably pegged to the Revelation 12 sign date of September 23rd, 2017. But there is the possibility still on the table that it can float around within that day counts that come after that too. And like Christ emphasized, make sure you read the book of Daniel to understand the events that will transpire with the abomination of desolation and afterwards too. And that also includes that there is a day count of 1,090 days from when the abomination is set up. When the Antichrist tells the world to make an image and they actually construct an image at that time, and then he causes everyone to worship it. From that notable point, from that notable day, it's going to be a single day. People will be able to do a day count of 1,290 days. And again, at a base understanding, we have to start with September 23rd, 2017. We know it is right there in between these two. It is literally between the account of the two witnesses and the account of what follows after that. It's literally right in between. So we know that is a celestial date marker where these two events on either side do hinge. But we also understand that there could be an offset of a few days in between them. The two witnesses will definitely give testimony for 1,260 days. They are going to be dead for 3.5 days after those days end. So is there a little bit of padding from when one count ends and the next one starts? Who knows? We also know time changes are going to be involved in there too. There is going to be an offset between those two. So we just have to always keep that in mind, a little caveat there, that yes, there is going to be an offset. We don't know how big, but everything does appear to revolve around the celestial date of September 23rd, 2017. We also understand that these day counts will have more significance once the tribulation actually starts. So 1,260 days after the Revelation 12 sign, in the future past, major events may happen. We are just within the time frame there, though. Also, there is long been understood that probably the mourning period, once Christ does arrive at the end of the tribulation, is probably going to be within this window too. That may explain the 30-day segment, the difference between 1,260 days and 1,090 days. That's a difference of 30 days. Is that the time of mourning that Scripture does say will happen? We don't know. But that would make sense, but we don't know for sure. And Daniel also tells us that there will be 1,335 days. Again, with that latter half of the tribulation ultimately pegged to, apparently, when the abomination is set up. Which, again, at a base understanding, is most likely pegged toward the September 23rd, 2017 celestial date that is recorded right at the transition between the two major day counts. So we know there are three significant day counts associated after the Revelation 12 sign, and with the events that happen apparently right around there with the abomination of desolation. But scripture does not delineate and actually say what happens at each one. It just says this will be an important day count, this will be an important day count, and then a little bit beyond that, this will also be an important day count. They're all important. That's all it says. There are a few details. It does tell us that the woman will be protected for 1,260 days and that the Antichrist will continue for 42 months, which is literally 1,260 days. So we know an ending process does apparently end at the conclusion of 1,260 days. So there is a basis to considering that the 1,260 days probably counts backwards from the 1,335 days. Again, we know that there is going to be some type of offset from between the two witnesses when they die and that little duration in between there. We know there's going to be a war in heaven. We know there's going to be some major, major events in between there before the Antichrist continues for 42 months and how the woman needs to be protected for only 1,260 days. So there's a lot to suggest that it's probably counting backwards from the end of 1,335 days. We do know that once the 1,260 days start, Satan will know his time is short, and that the woman will only need to be protected for 1,260 days. So there are longer day counts given, but we know she will only have to be protected for that time, so it's probably backed up to the final and latter day count. Which again, when we consider all these different day counts and the possibility that 1,260 days is backed up to the end, we know within this window is apparently, when the tribulation will end, pegged to the celestial date, when Christ will return to set up his millennial kingdom, when the woman no longer needs protection, and when the time of mourning will start. Somewhere within those three day counts, that is where that expectation is. It's also apparently the time frame just prior to that, when the tribulation would start. When Christ returns for his wise and faithful servants at the rapture, the harpazo promise, and also when the sudden destruction, the snare loop, starts. Somewhere within those day counts when Satan knows his time is short. It's all pegged to this time frame right here, just these few days after the Revelation 12 sign. Satan knows his time is short, and apparently it's right around here, because the next prophetic events will happen right on time. So again, there are certain things we can't say about the specifics of the day counts, why each one is important. All we know is they are very important, and Satan will know his time is short, pegged to 1,260 days somewhere within that. So again, the more that we look at this time frame where we are now, within these day counts associated with the Revelation 12 sign, we don't dismiss certain things. We reflect on why we're even looking at this time. The more that we reflect on what has our Father shown us back for months and years and years and years, that reinforces and recalls the memory everything that he has shown us. And if we're honest with ourselves, we understand that is why we're even looking at this time now. Because of what our Father worked, showing his hand, giving wisdom and understanding to bring us to this time on this learning journey. We are here looking at this time because what our Father has shown us. And that is how we see the day approaching. That is how we know our redemption draweth nigh. That's how we are even looking for the redemption promise, the harpazo promise. Because we see all these things beginning to come to pass, we've looked up, we've lifted up our heads, just like he told us, and we have seen some incredible things that tie directly to our redemption. The one who was born of a virgin, the one who came as the Lamb of God to be offered on our behalf. That is the one we are expecting to pick up his purchased possession. And so, friend, again, this goes hand in hand with what we see the Lord working here on the ground level with the Rapture Library. We should not be surprised when we look at the timeline, when we consider the time. Why do we know the time? Do we know what time it is? And why do we know this time? It's because of the learning journey that our Father has shown us. when we looked into Scripture, when we looked up into the heavens, when we looked and saw everything beginning to come to pass, we knew our redemption draweth nigh. We could see the day approaching. Our Father has shown us so much. And when we consider that He has shown us so much as an interactive learning journey, library of information along this whole path, where we consider the time and shortness, how it appears so short, and the redemption of the promises that our Redeemer gave us, we should not be surprised that He is calling for a condensing of all the information that He has shown us so that we could pass on to others, because this is what should be expected here at this late hour when we are expected to be leaving, to pass on for those the information that they will need too, because they are going to see all those same signs again. They are going to see the sign of the Son of Man. They are going to see some incredible events that we haven't seen as well. All in context, though, of what we have seen. And the more that we can pass on to them the opportunity and treasure that we have seen, the incredible impact and blessing in the days ahead. And especially the more that we reflect on all that our Father has shown us, it should really impress upon us the responsibility we have to pass on what our Father has shown us. And should not be surprised that our Father is now giving us the opportunity right here at these very day counts associated with the celestial signs that He's been showing us for years and years and years, showing us how it all comes together and how we can pass it on to the future, to those in the days ahead. Friend, this is why we are told the lateness of the hour. This is why we are told to watch. It's not for trivia information. It's not for morbid curiosity. It is so that we can act on what we see, so we can act on what our Father shows us, so we can see the fields are white into harvest now, so we can see the lateness of the hour and redeem today, so we can redeem so many opportunities for souls. The more that we see the lateness of the hour, the more we should see the opportunities. We should also see the responsibility based all on why do we know what time it is. And the more that we know what time it is, we know what's coming next. And we also know that there are going to be many lives and souls that will be affected. So we have a double responsibility to take the information that our Father shows us and share with those in the days ahead. And our manner of showing it to them will demonstrate love and compassion, that we want them to have this information that will help them, not just in the temporal life, but in the eternal as well. There comes a responsibility the more we understand why do we know what time it is. Definitely check out our website, rapturelibrary.com. Today, just go there, look at the information, review the booklets, just take a gander through all that our Father has shown us. Just reflect on the learning journey, your own prophetic learning journey. And yes, other watchmen have been involved, but just reflect on all the information that our Father has shown you over the months and years and years and years, and why this time has so much importance. And with that understanding comes a great weight of responsibility. And this is what we need to consider here at this late hour. Why should we redeem the time? Because it is incredibly valuable and we have an incredible responsibility. So definitely visit the Rapture Library. It's for Christians the day before the rapture. It does us well to reflect on what our Father has shown us and why and how we see the day approaching. Definitely download a PDF, Operation Burning Lamp, to consider and reflect on all the opportunities, the potential of how we can pass on for those in the days ahead our learning journey. The talent and treasure of information that our Father has placed in our hands. What are we doing with it? What are we doing with it? The more that we reflect on these day counts, we need to see it as a conclusion of a journey that the Lord has shown us for years. And we also need to consider we are running out of days and hours. There's so much within this time, the very time that commemorates when the Harpazo promise was given. We are told to look up, to lift up our heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. What are we doing? Are we watching ourselves? Are we taking heed to ourselves? Are we taking heed to the opportunities that our Father shows us about why we know the time and hour is so very late? Are we watching for opportunities? Are we watching for our Father to work? What are we watching as we know that time is so very short? The more that we reflect on all that our Father has shown us over months and years, the more we should realize we have no excuses of not to use what He has placed into our hand. The more it should impress upon us the weight of the responsibility we have to pass on to those in the days ahead. To pass on today. To redeem the time today. What are we doing with all the huge treasure of information that He has shown us about this time? What's just on the horizon? We have no excuse of not to rise up, to trim our lamps and to shine bright. We have no excuse in the light of the weight of information that our Father has shown us. To not do anything would be foolish. What are we doing? Are we shining bright? This is why the Apostle Paul urged us and encouraged us. Let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together as a manner of some is, but exhorting, imploring, inviting one another, and so much the more, as ye see the day approaching. What should you be doing as you see the day approaching? Sitting back and doing nothing? No, so much the more, we should be rising up in service because we see the day approaching. Demonstrating love, demonstrating good works. Considering those in the days ahead, considering those around us, considering the lateness of the hour, considering the valuableness of the opportunities that our Father has placed into our hands. And that is the whole reason why we are even watching this time, because He has shown the time to us. And it would be the highest insult to our Father to not take how He has shown us the time, the information that He's put right into our hands, the treasure of information He's put into our hands, and to disregard it and not even care to pass it on to those in the days ahead. To not do anything with it, but just wrap it up in a little napkin of knowledge for trivia information. But friend, to be a wise and faithful servant, we will see and we will look and we will reflect on what our Father has placed into our hands, the journey He has taken us on, so much He has shown us, the treasure He has given us. Father, what have You given us? Master, Lord, what have You placed into our hands, the talents of treasure You have placed into our hands that have great accountability and responsibility? Lord, how can we use this to bring forth fruit for Your kingdom, to bring forth fruit for Your glory? Lord, show me, give me wisdom of how I can take what You have shared freely with me, how I can share it freely with those in the days ahead. And the more that we ask Him for wisdom, the more that we ask Him for strength, He will show us opportunities, He will show us the needs, and we should go forward boldly, faithfully, without even making excuses. Lord, I will do what You want me to do. No excuses. I'm not going to blame somebody else. I'm not going to try to shift the blame. I'm going to be responsible for what You have given me, because I'm the one responsible, because I'm the one accountable. And Lord, You have given me so much. I know I can see the day approaching. I know what time it is, because of what You have given to me. And so, therefore, I will use what You have given to me and share with others, considering others, demonstrating love and good works, and so much more, using what You have given me in urgency as we see the day approaching. A demonstration of gratitude to our Father, because He is the one who has shown us the day approaching. Friend, I want to invite you to be a part of the Rapture Library, because it's part of our journey. It is the whole reason why we know what time it is, why we see the day approaching. It's because of this learning journey that the Lord has brought us on for months and years and years and years. And what He is calling and showing us is how we can put together all the same information that stirred in us, stirred in our hearts, stirred in our lives. This is why so many things have been done for Christ over the past few years. It's because of knowing the lateness hour. So many have risen up to redeem the time, to reach out to so many souls over the past few years. This is why. And when we think of the fire that has burned in so many hearts just because of this information that the Lord has shown us on this learning journey, how much more in the days ahead will it burn bright for Christ, a light that the world can see, a testimony for Jesus Christ and the Word of God, the faithfulness of God's Word and prophecy and time in our world. God's Word is true. How many lives has it changed? How many more lives can it change? Friend, I want you to be a part of what our Father is working. It is so incredible. The more that we reflect on what He has done and how many countless thousands of lives have already been touched by this learning journey and how many more we can reach in the days ahead. And friend, I want you to be a part of it. I want you to be a part of it. Our very own Redeemer is the one who emphasized, do you see the whiteness of the fields that are ready for harvest right now? Do you realize how late the hour is? Do you realize what time it is? There are opportunities that are slipping through your fingers right now. Act on the opportunities now. Launch out into the deep and let down your net. There are opportunities all around you, and particularly when we see a huge opportunity right here in the days ahead, right here at this threshold, where we realize we are so short on time. We do not know how much time we have left, but we do know we are running out of that time. Will we act on the opportunities that our very own Redeemer has led us for years and years to show us the opportunity and the weight of this important prophetic hour and the incredible opportunity for souls, the incredible draft of fish that are here at this late hour? For years and years and years, we have heard the trumpet calls at midnight. The bridegroom cometh, your Redeemer cometh, your redemption draweth nigh, the day is approaching. Go ye out to meet Him. Go out to meet Him. Show action. Don't just talk about it. Go out to meet them. Demonstrate it with your life. Put feet and action to what you believe. Considering others, considering yourself, of what your Father has shown you. The trumpet calls your bridegroom has made to you. Are you also telling others with the same heart as the bridegroom? He that is athirst, let him take the water of life freely. What are we doing when we hear the midnight cry? Are we rising up? Are we trimming our lamps? Are we shining bright? Are we girded in a service? Let's be found so, friend, as we go forward together. You and me together. Let's rise up. Let's go out to meet the bridegroom. Demonstrating that we hear him. Demonstrating that we will heed and obey him. Demonstrating that we love him. And demonstrating that we will serve him first and highest above all else. Launching out into the deep and letting down the nets. Till he comes. Maranatha.